Welcome everyone. So now we are going to start hepatology, and this one is most important in clinical point of view. And a lot of cases, a lot of patients are there from hepatology. And so now let's start it. So the first topic is jaundice. Jaundice is referred to yellow discoloration of sclera, skin, and mucous membrane. So it refers to increase in bilirubin concentration in the body when bilirubin is increased because of certain causes. As we know that bilirubin comes from hemoglobin. Portion of hemoglobin converts into porphyrin, and then that porphyrin is converted into the bilirubin. So when that bilirubin is increased in our body, a condition develops that is known as jaundice, and it is yellowish discoloration of skin, sclera, and mucous membrane. And the jaundice is detectable clinically when plasma concentration exceeds 40 micromole per liter, 2.5 milligram per deciliter, and then condition develops that is known as jaundice. Now, bilirubin metabolism, unconjugated bilirubin, also known as indirect bilirubin, it is lipid soluble, and it is end product of heme degradation. As you know, in this picture, hemoglobin is broken down into two portions. One is globin, another is heme. Now, globin is protein part, heme is a reabsorbed, and heme is broken down into porphyrin and iron, and porphyrin is converted into bilirubin. That is unconjugated bilirubin, and it goes into liver for conjugation, and it is conjugated with albumin. Albumin is bounded with this bilirubin, and that bilirubin is known as bilirubin glucuronidase. That is conjugated, and it goes into the small intestine, and from small intestine it is excreted as stercobilinogen, and some portion of that is reabsorbed back, and some portion goes into the kidney for excretion, and that is known as urobilinogen. So that is unconjugated bilirubin. Now this is conjugated bilirubin. It is direct bilirubin, and it is water soluble. When unconjugated bilirubin is conjugated by hepatic UDP glucuronyl transferase, which is enzyme, then that unconjugated bilirubin is converted into conjugated bilirubin. Being water soluble, only loosely bound to albumin. This is loosely bound to albumin, and it is water soluble, and it goes into the intestine for excretion as stercobilinogen, and some portion is reabsorbed back into the liver, and some portion is goes to the kidney for excretion as urobilinogen, and some portion is excreted in the urine. It is stored in gallbladder and released into duodenum via common bile duct. Now this is normal physiology. It is stored in gallbladder, and at the time of contraction it is released into duodenum and excreted out of the body. But now what happens in those patients who have surgical resection of duodenum? They develop different complications related to this. So we will discuss all these diseases related to this physiology derangement. Now this conjugated bilirubin is converted into urobilinogen in intestinal bacteria, and that urobilinogen is reabsorbed into the kidney, and from there it is excreted out of the body. Urobilinogen is 80% of urobilinogen is converted into urobilin and excreted into feces, while 20% of urobilinogen is recycled to the liver for 90% and excreted in the kidney and urine for 10%. So that was jaundice. And that was unconjugated bilirubin and conjugated bilirubin. So the main two difference between unconjugated and conjugated bilirubin is lipid soluble, and it is indirect, goes into the liver for conjugation, and from there it becomes water soluble and excreted from small intestine and kidney in form of urobilinogen. So in next video we will discuss types of unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia, and its further subtypes, diseases related to that, hemolytic jaundice, and different diseases related to bilirubin.